Yeah, can I start now?
Yes, professor, you can start now, yeah.
Yes, okay. Hello all, welcome. I hope you're keeping safe during the current pandemic. Okay, welcome to the webinar on MTech in Computer-Aided Structural Engineering. Okay. This webinar is related to our new master's program in computer-aided structural engineering at Mahindra University, wherein this webinar provides you a platform for the prospective students to know about Mahindra University and what is about the computer-aided structural engineering, what we are about to offer. And also you can clarify your doubts, if any, during this webinar. So I welcome you all. So in this webinar, I'm going to talk about the computer-aided structural engineering, which is in short known as CASE. So I'm going to talk about vision, mission of the program, and mainly important thing is the curriculum of the program. And after knowing the curriculum, the key differentiators which the Mahindra University is going to offer in the curriculum, and then why you have to join Mahindra University for the MTech in computer-aided structural engineering. What is the advantage you get at Mahindra University? Whether it might be with respect to the faculty strength, the infrastructure we have, the research centers which aid to the program, the national and the international collaborations which do provide the internships and the placement opportunities, the research exchanges, students exchanges, etc., and the current research projects which the faculty are working on. And at the end, I'll also talk about the career prospects of the structural engineering and specifically about the computer-aided structural engineering. And then the last is the most important one is a question answer session where I would be I hope that I would clarify all your doubts related to the program. So about CASE, so the computer-aided structural engineering at Mahindra University, by this program we try to give an in-depth knowledge related to the mathematical modeling and the computational methods in order to design and analyze simple to the complex structures. The CASE at MU, it integrates the analytical and the programming skills to the core structural engineering. Okay. We kept intact. If you look into the curriculum, which I'll be talking about in the coming slides, the core structural engineering is been intact as a skeleton, and then we have been dressed up with the programming skills which are required for the present and the future structural engineer, so that they can solve the complex designs and understand the coding which is behind those complex designs and able to solve it. The vision of the program is to inherent strength of computer programming into the structural engineering. So as I told you that we have kept intact the core structural engineering, and then we have add on to that structural engineering the programming, so that we can provide a robust and accurate, fast, economical, and sustainable solutions for the current and the future challenges. Let me open the pointer option. There's a pointer, right? The main specific program education objectives include to provide proficiency in advanced principles of structural engineering, so that the students can be able to formulate, analyze, and then deliver technical solutions to the infrastructure problem by viewing it in a holistical way, so that they can build a sustainable environment. We also plan to expose students to the latest innovations and futuristic technological trends. If you look into the curriculum, you can understand what are these latest innovations which we have added in the curriculum and the futuristic technological trends. so that it can inculcate in the student the strong orientation, research orientation to the application of structural engineering. This program also hopes to produce structural engineers who can integrate and build on the program's core curricular concepts, keeping the structural core intact in pursuit of professional leadership, your teamwork, lifelong learning, and successful career advancement. The program's specific outcomes include to develop analytical, computational, and programming skills which are being required to analyze and design so that they can provide a sustainable solution for the new and the aging infrastructure problems. We also plan, the program expects to equip the required skills in the students so that they can either become a design consultant or an entrepreneur or take up the research in the relevant field. The program exposes students to the state of art technological and sustainable solutions using the latest technology, that is artificial intelligence and building information modeling for either monitoring, repairs, retrofitting, 3D printing, so that the students are prepared to face the future challenges. The proposed program in computer aided structural engineering is MTech for 2 years or master's MS in research for 2 years. Then you can convert into PhD and then there can be an integrated PhD too. The eligibility is BTech or BE in civil engineering with a 60% minimum marks. And the selection is depending on two criteria. One is based on the percentile score in GATE examination, with the cutoff is 85%, or else you can have a written examination conducted by Mahindra University. Okay, all the shortlisted candidates based on the above two criteria will have to appear for the personal interview to have the final selections. Related to the fee for the GATE qualified students, we offer TA ships so that the stipend of 12K per month is being paid to them. Plus, there's a free boarding and lodging. For the non-GATE students, the fees is around 3 lakh per annum, along with the hostel fee. Coming to the curriculum, which is an important part of the program. As I told you that in the curriculum, the core structure is intact with an addition of the programming and analytical skills in order to prepare the students for the industry requirement. So in the first semester, the curriculum for the 2 years is divided into 4 semesters, where in the first semester, you'll be studying about 7 courses. These 2 courses, the Python programming and building visualization courses, these two courses will run one after the other. That means the Python programming will be running for around 1.5 months during the start of the semester. And then once the Python programming is completed, then the building visualization would start after that. The reason behind this is we want the students to first learn about the programming skills so that they can use those programming skills in the core courses. So if you look into the numerical methods and programming, I think I need to change the pointer options. Is the pointer connected? Yeah. The numerical methods using programming. As you look into the curriculum, this is a conventional numerical methods curriculum. But the important thing in this course is the culmination of the programming language, which is being used to implement all these techniques which you learn in the numerical methods. So that is the new thing in this program. And then coming to the applied elasticity and plasticity, as you can see that all the boundary value problems or else the stress field, the application of the torsion on the prism problems, all those conventional things which you will be learning and those problems, apart from the analytical methods, you will be also required to use coding to visualize the solution and perform the parametric study, wherein wherein you can understand by doing a parametric study, you can understand how the things would be changing with respect to the change in the parameters. And then the computational structural dynamics, okay, the single degree of freedom system, the multiple degree of freedom system, all those conventional things you'll be learning along with the programming, so that the response of the system subjected to earthquake ground motion, you'll be able to visualize it and understand in a better manner. Then the other course, which is on advanced cementitious composites, it is a very important course, as you know that in order to have a sustainable built environment, it is the structural engineer would also require to be known the materials. The structural engineer should also be aware of the materials which are sustainable to be used in the structure, rather than optimizing the design. Apart from optimizing the design, he should be aware of the sustainable materials which can be used in the structures. So this course will deal about those advanced cementitious components which can be used for the sustainable built environment, wherein you will be studying about the latest technologies such as the 3D printing, the rheology of the fresh concrete for the 3D printable mixes, so on and so forth. And then the important course on computer-aided structural design 1, that is reinforced concrete, where you will be studying about the singly reinforced beam, doubly reinforced, the flat slabs, deep beams, corals, elevated water tanks, so on and so forth. You'll be studying about the design, and also you'll be writing the programming exercises which will be dedicated to the development of either using the MATLAB or the Python codes, so that you can design using these codes. And the first semester, it consists of 18 credits of 7 courses. Then we'll be moving on to the second semester, which consists of 6 courses of 20 credits, wherein you will be having 2 open electives in the second semester, combined with 4 core courses. The first course in the second semester is infrastructure health monitoring. As you know that in the developing country like India, if you look into the infrastructure is aging. So it is very necessary in order to monitor these aging infrastructure and also the new infrastructure which is being developed. So the structural engineer should be aware of how to monitor these aging and the new infrastructure which is going to be built, whether by using the sensors, and how to analyze the data, how to acquire the data, how to interpret the data. It is very, very important. So in this course, you will be learning about all those techniques, how to monitor the infrastructure health. And you will be also learning about how to utilize those voluminous data which you collect, which you acquire using those sensors with the latest technologies such as AI and ML. Then the second course in the second semester is the programming finite element method. As the name implies, you'll be learning about the finite element principles along with the programming. Okay, where you use the programming using Python in order to develop the 2D or the 3D stress elements, material non-linearity, or the temperature induced force. Coming to the important course, earthquake resistant design. Here also you will be studying about the core earthquake resistant design, how to design the structure which can resist the earthquake. And here you will be studying adding upon the design with the application of artificial intelligence in seismology, and how to use those seismological graphs by the artificial intelligence techniques. Then the fourth core course in the semester 2 is a computer aided structural design 2, which is a steel course, steel structures. Here also the design which you are going to do, it whether beam design, plate girder design, the industrial building design, or a truss design, the silos or the steel bunkers. Okay, you will be doing the design along with the along with a programming language. And then coming to the third semester, you have an department elective. The department electives, there are various courses in the basket. You can have a retrofitting and rehabilitation retrofitting course, or else a sustainable material course, the bridge engineering, design of bridge structures course, and so forth, followed by a capstone project on software development, where you will be given a project where you need to develop your own software in order to design the structure, followed by industrial internship. And then in the third semester, we do have a very important industry seminars wherein we'll be calling the eminent personalities in the field in order to deliver lecture, so that the students can understand how the courses which they have studied in the curriculum would be helpful in the real field. And then the thesis, the program thesis is divided into two parts. One is part one would be done in the semester three for 4 credits, and then the fourth semester is entirely credited for the thesis of 12 credits. These master's theses, the students can work at the industry, or else they can take up a research project under any professor and complete their master's thesis. If you look into the entire curriculum, the gist of the entire curriculum can be divided into three categories: the design courses, the analysis courses, and the advanced courses. And the total credits of the program is around 62. Now coming to the key differentiators, why you have to join Mahindra University for the computer-aided structural engineering. The three differentiators is, the first one is the 3D printing technology. Okay, you'll have a course, you can see the related courses which deal with these 3D printing technologies. So this is a very important technology where the students will be making aware the students about how to develop the printable mix concrete, and how the slippage of the bond layers in the concrete. Okay, and you can see that three of our students, they have launched a startup in 2018 known as Favo Construction Technologies, related to the 3D printing technology. They have filed 2 patents and they have executed their first project in Basra, where they have built 10 units of 30 square meter cottages using this 3D printing technology. So you will have a leverage to look into that technology and work with them. The other key differentiator is the application of the artificial intelligence in the structural engineering and structural health monitoring. As you might be aware that when you monitor the health of a structure, when you acquire the data using sensors, there will be a voluminous data. And in order to analyze that voluminous data and interpret the health of the structure, you need latest advanced technologies. So here we'll be using the artificial intelligence in order to analyze those data and interpret the results, so that you can make a faster decision and you can increase the computational efficiency for the complex designs. Then the other key differentiator is advanced technologies for earthquake resistant structures. In this course, the students will be learning about the different latest technologies for making the structure earthquake resistant. The prospects of this course would be development of seismic microzonation map, okay, and the National Disaster Management Authority projects. Okay, the latest technology is the base isolation and the tuned mass dampers. So these would be the prospects of learning this course. And then the other key differentiator is a sustainable habitat. As we know that the concrete, which is being widely used next to water, is the largest carbon dioxide emitter, and the people are looking for alternative materials so that we can have a sustainable built environment. So in this course, you will be learning about those sustainable materials, for example, bamboo, for example, geopolymer concrete, which is 100% free cement concrete, for example, limestone calcium clay concrete, where there is a 50% reduction of the clinker. Okay, so this elective course would be built upon the sustainable materials which are very much required for the future constructions. And the other is a structural rehabilitation. So the scope of this course would be the non-destructive evaluation and how to retrofit the existing structure if at all it is not fit for functionality after doing the structural health assessment. So you'll be learning about the different techniques, how to retrofit the structure without dismantling it. And then next, knowing the curriculum and the key differentiators, I'll be telling you about what is the advantage at MU. When you study the Masters in Computer-Aided Structural Engineering at MU, what is the leverage and the advantage which you get? The strength at MU, Department of Civil Engineering at MU, is their faculty. Okay, I'll be talking more about the faculty in the coming slide, where I'll be explaining you about their research areas, their work done, so and so forth. So all the faculty, we have doctorate faculty from the premier institutions around the world. So this is the biggest strength of the program and the department and the university as a whole. Okay, and the research center which aid to the program, we have different research center, the sustainable infrastructure and system center, artificial intelligence, 5G material testing center, so on and so forth, which aid to the program to enhance the skills of the students. And the experimental facilities wherein we have the structural engineering laboratory, health monitoring laboratory, dynamics and advanced testing material laboratory. Apart from the experimental, we do have a computing facilities where we have a wireless innovation and 5G testbed, design studio, supercomputing facility where we have a supercomputer by NVIDIA. And the most important thing for the students is a collaboration which we have with the industry so that they can work for their internship and can convert that internship into a placement offers. And we do have a national and international university collaboration where the students who are interested in doing research can work over there in their summer so that they can access to their laboratories and work in the relevant area. We do have professional organization collaborations wherein we closely work with the organizations in order to improve the codes or work on the code, developing the codes, so and so forth. Coming to the faculty, which is the biggest strength, this is Dr. Prabhakar Singh, our head of the department. Okay, his PhD is from Washington State University and his core research area is in the water resource engineering. So he works on hydrological modeling, water zone hydrology, the climate change impact on crops. So he's basically a water resource engineer person working on how to optimize the resources related to water management. Then we have a very senior professor as an adjunct faculty in the department, an asset to the department, Professor Ganesh Babu. He's a former director, CSIR, CBRI, and former professor at IIT Madras. His core areas are the structural design, wherein he has designed numerous bridges, ports and harbors, developing sustainable materials. He had recently published two books on high performance self-consolidating cementitious composites and mathematical modeling of concrete mixture proportionality. Okay. Apart from these research areas, he has expertise in service life assessment and rehabilitation technologies, heritage and monument protection, nuclear radiation shielding composites and non-destructive techniques. Then it's myself, Professor Visalakshi, a PhD from IIT Delhi. My research area includes structural health monitoring using piezo sensors. As you can see that this is a concrete specimen wherein you bond the piezo sensors. You can monitor its strength, how the strength is been developing at different hours, or else you can monitor the durability of the concrete wherein in the healthy state and the corroded state, how the variation in the signature is there, or else you can monitor the damaged location if at all there is a damage in the structure. And develop durability of novel SEM, sustainable materials, wherein I work with the natural-based materials or artificial posidonias. I do work in engineered bamboo structure, where we are trying to build a rural housing blocks in hexagonal shape with the help of these engineered bamboo, wherein all these columns, beams, the intersection of these columns, beam, everything is of bamboo, a sustainable material for the rural housing. Then we have Professor Ataullah Khan, PhD from Khalifa University. He works on theoretical and computational mechanics of material interfaces. He work on 3D printing of concrete, wherein he is developing the characteristics of printable concrete. He also works on hybrid fiber reinforced concrete and also durability of geopolymer concrete. This is a geopolymer concrete, which is 100% cement free concrete, a sustainable material for the future. We have Dr. Jaya Prakash Vemuri, PhD from IIT Delhi and MS from UWO Canada. He has expertise in characterization of strong ground motions, has extensive work done on earthquake resistant masonry structures. He do work on generation of synthetic ground motions for the earthquake and nonlinear time history analysis of structures, seismic risk assessment, so on and so forth. Then this is Dr. Venkat Dilip, M.Tech and PhD from IIIT Hyderabad. He's working on live projects. He's a live project person. He does lot of live monitoring of bridges. As you can see that his research areas include earthquake engineering, structural health monitoring, heritage conservation, smart structures using ML and AI, retrofitting, rehabilitation. He's working on different live projects wherein in this figure you can see the live monitoring and assessment of this bridge when the train is been passing. Okay. His work also include Digi Encyclopedia of Indian Traditional Houses. He want to digitalize the traditional construction, which is an important as far as structural engineers are concerned. And then he do work on heritage conservation and modeling. Then we have Dr. Subha Rao, M.Tech and PhD from IIT Bombay. He is a transportation engineering specialized person, wherein he works on the travel and the traffic behavior analysis using the application of ML and big data. How the transit-oriented development, analyzing its impact on land use and the built environment. Okay, the travel demand modeling and the choice modeling, public transportation systems and ride hail services. So these are the areas he works on. We have other faculty, Dr. Deepti, whose PhD is from IIT Hyderabad. Her work extensively on sustainable and secondary pavement materials. She works on the materials for the pavement, how to develop sustainable materials, its impacts, so on and so forth, and emission measurements, mitigation technologies, etc. We have Dr. Hari Prasad, M.Tech and PhD in Geotechnical Engineering from IIT Hyderabad. Okay. His expertise is in soil reinforcement interaction, quality control of pavement layers using non-destructive methods, how to stabilize the soil using sustainable materials and soil structure interaction, which is very important from the foundation's point of view. And I think we need to very closely working with the Hari Prasad for the soil structure interaction for the construction of the buildings. We have Dr. Jyoti, PhD from IIT Guwahati, University of Utah. She's an environmental engineering person, wherein she works on pre-treatment of lignocellulosic waste anaerobic digestion, solid waste management, which is need of the hour. Solid waste management. She's extensively working on that. Organic waste utilization, biological treatment, and the landfill leachate, etc. Coming to the research centers at Mahindra Universities, we have the first research center is the Center for Sustainable Infrastructure and System. Currently, around 15 research scholars from civil, computer science, and electrical departments are working in this center. This center has been founded by one of our civil engineering faculty, Dr. Dilip, and computer science faculty, Professor Prafula. The key areas of this center is the earthquake engineering, structural health monitoring and assessment, 3D modeling of heritage structures, smart structures, product development, and they use the latest technologies such as artificial intelligence, machine learning, image processing, data analysis, computational coding, wireless sensors in order to work on live projects. This center has completed many projects, and there are many projects in the pipeline which they are working upon. You can see the visual inspections, laboratory developing the laboratory prototype models, knowledge sharing, 3D modeling of heritage structures. They develop crack detection software. They have developed a software wherein it can detect the crack. Whether it's an active crack or else it's a passive crack, and then drive project simulations. Okay, the center has institute collaborations with all these institutes wherein they have a student exchange program and they collaborate extensively in the research. They have industry collaboration with these industries wherein the students can work there as an intern and can convert that internship into a placement offer. They are working on the industry-sponsored research project presently on structural health assessment and monitoring of structures using wireless sensors and artificial intelligence. It's a three-year project which is underway. And these are our BTEC students who have brought a lot of accolades to the department and to the university in their undergraduate program itself by participating in international conferences and getting West Paper Awards. As you can see that many students have participated in various international conferences in Malaysia, Cyprus, Sri Lanka, Italy, so on and so forth. The other research center we have is a center of excellence in artificial intelligence, wherein they have a technology of convolutional neural network architecture, neural training algorithms, cognitive modeling, fuzzy clustering, game theory concepts, so on and so forth, where you can apply in different areas. For structural engineering point of view, you can apply these technologies in the earthquake engineering, in structural health monitoring, and in rehabilitation, retrofitting, so on and so forth. Okay, the supporting infrastructure this center has is a supercomputer lab with advanced NVIDIA GPU-based supercomputing facility. This center of excellence works for academicians and researchers, global as well as locals, for the corporate and the private. For the leading startups, entrepreneurs, national missions, technocrat, and government bodies. And we have an MOU with the Telangana government for the D-Hub, wherein we have been collaborated with other universities such as IIIT Hyderabad, IIT Hyderabad, etc. Then we have the other center on wireless innovation and 5G lab, where we have a 5G IoT real-time test bed, which can be useful for our smart housing, wherein all the devices of the house can be connected to the IoT, and this center will also help us in wireless sensor monitoring for the structural health monitoring, etc. So this is the wireless and the 5G lab, where we have different wireless networks. Apart from the centers, the department do have the inter-industry collaboration, as I was mentioning, wherein the students can leverage with these industries, where they can work for the summer internship, or else for the they can work their project in these companies and convert that into a placement offer. We do have academic collaboration with the leading universities in India and abroad. As you can see, that we do have the Ghent University, Sun China Building Materials Academy, China, NTNU, UTM, and also with more or less all the IITs, we do have collaboration wherein we have a student exchange program, or else we are working very closely for the research projects with these IITs. Apart from universities, we do have collaboration with the professional organizations such as RILEM, which is an international organization for the development of construction materials and systems. And we have collaboration with NACE International Organization, which is an organization for the corrosion engineers. And we have with the IASTRUCE, the Indian Association of Structural Engineers, and the Indian Concrete Institute, wherein we work very closely with these organizations in order to develop the codes, to write the summary for the codes, and myself being a honorary secretary of Indian Association of Structural Engineers and also the treasurer of Indian Concrete Institute will be an added advantage for the students to connect with these professional organizations, where they can bridge the gap and closely work with the professionals in the industry to convert their theoretical knowledge into a practical application. The lab facilities at Mahindra Universities include the structural health and assessment lab, the building information modeling lab for the visualization, and this design studio for designing the structures, and the material testing lab for advanced testing, whether it's the fresh properties, durability properties, or the hardened properties of all the sustainable materials. Now, coming to the career prospects after studying the master's program, the career prospects of the structural engineering is very bright, as you can see in this slide, that the future of structural engineering in India for the next 10 years, this is given by the Business Economics India Limited, wherein there is a demand of around 95 billion square feet in the real estate and the construction industry. And also the important thing is there is a demand supply gap ranging between 82 to 86% of skilled civil engineering or architects. So here it is very important to know that the skills are very important, and at Mahindra that is our motive to provide the required skills for the students in order to take up the latest and the future challenges in infrastructure. If you come to the growth, developing faster than any other sector, because India is a developing country and infrastructure is very, very eminent in order to develop the country. So the growth, if you look into the growth, is developing faster than ever. And if you look into the international market value, the civil engineering industry is expected to reach a size of $11.72 trillion by 2025. So there is a huge international market as well for the civil engineer and the structural engineer. So the future of civil engineer or the structural engineer specifically is not limited to the geographical boundaries of the country. Okay. According to the report by Global Market Insights, it says that it is expected to reach around 11.72 trillions by 2025. The main reason for such a rapid development of this discipline is the rise in the population and urbanization. So the student can work on sustainable infrastructure solution, green building, built environment, and more all over the globe. And if you look into the demand, as I mentioned, that it has been predicted that the real estate is going to have a demand of around 95 billion square feet And the report by Royal Institute of Chartered Surveyors says that the country needs 4 million skilled civil engineers until next year. Not only the future of the civil and the structural engineers are bright. If you look into the government schemes, if you look into the various government schemes, such as Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, where you have to build the housing for all, okay, you need a structural engineer. For the smart cities of India, in order to build them, the Bharatmala projects, where the highways are being laid, and the tunnels, in order to construct the tunnels, you need a structural engineer. And the Sagarmala project, wherein in order to construct the ports, harbors, you need a structural engineer. Not only the schemes, if you look into the budget which has been assigned for the infrastructure development is also very huge. As you can see from these are all pictures, you can see the investment, how much the government is been investing in the infrastructure development. So this, the future is very bright for a structural engineer. So knowing the future, if you look into the career opportunities, from the curriculum point of view, the curriculum is basically into the design courses, analysis courses, and the advanced courses. So with these three heads, the student can either become a structural engineer or a consultant engineer, where they can develop their own consultancy, CAD, CA developer, or they can move into the research. So if you want to be a structural engineer or else a consultants engineer, these are the companies, not limited to, but which can be preferred for a structural or a consultant engineer. For a CAD/CAM developer, they can go into these software developing companies. And if you want to do research, then you can go for a PhD, or you can join any research labs. Okay, so these would be the career opportunities for a structural engineer after doing their MTech. So that's it from my side. So I request all the participants to put up their questions in the question box so that I can answer them. I'll try my best to answer all the queries related to the program. So the first question is, what are the probable dates of the examination? Yeah, as I told you that we have two options to get into the program. One is through GATE. The cutoff is 85%, or else you have to write an entrance at Mahindra University. The probable dates would be in the first year, second week, in the month of July, probably, maybe in the second or third week of July. Okay, the last date for the application is 15, but it probably be extended to the end of this month. So after receiving the applications, then the date of examination will be conveyed, and it will be probably tentatively in the mid of June also. The mailing address, yes, I've given here in the slide. Okay, you can mail to case@mahindrauniversity.edu.in for any questions. Jai Prakash, I think you can note down this mail ID and you can send me any queries wherein we can clarify your queries related to the program. The other question is related to the scholarship. The scholarship, as I've mentioned in the presentation, that the scholarship is being provided to the GATE qualified students, 15,000, okay, along with free boarding and lodging, wherein a TA ship is being assigned to those students who have been provided the scholarship. The other question is related to the project, MTech project. The project is being divided into two parts. One, the part one, you are going to do it in the third semester, and the fourth semester, 6 months entirely is dedicated for the part two. So for the part two, for the part one and part two, either you can do a research project, okay, under the faculty, or else you can do an industry project. As I mentioned, that we have collaboration with various industries, so you can work at any one of the industries related to the project for 6 months to 1 year entirely in the industry for the project. For any information on MTech related to computer-aided structural engineering, you may visit our website www.mahindraecolecentrale.edu.in and the programs and the MTech computer-aided structural engineering. All the information is being provided over there. Or else you can mail us to this mail ID. There's a question from Kaniyappan. Can we join after completing ME Structural Engineering? You want to again do the master's? If you want to join, again do the master's. Okay. The eligibility is bachelor's with 60% of 60% percentage marks. So you are eligible to, if you are willing to again do the master's program, yes, you are eligible to. You can join, provided you have the requisite criteria of 60% in BTech. And if you have a GATE score of 85%, then you can directly attend the interview. Or else you can write the entrance exam of Mahindra University, followed by personal interview. Thank you, Kaniyappan.
Professor, if there are no further questions, probably then we can wrap up.
Yeah, I think I don't think there are any more questions. So yeah, we can wind up this session. Thank you so much. You can write to this mail ID in case you have any questions related to the program, or else you can go to our website and look out for more information about the program. Thank you so much. Thank you, Rakesh.